What is another common name after COVID that you're hearing a lot these days? This is vitamin C. So today we are going to know everything related to vitamin C, including the definition, medication, dosage, how you're supposed to take it, what can overdosage lead to, and what deficiency can lead to. But before that, we'll be moving with the definition of vitamins. Vitamins are organic substances which are required in small quantity in the body. Usually, they are not synthesized in the body, and so we are supposed to take them from an outside diet. Vitamins can be of two types. It can be water-soluble or fat-soluble. The water-soluble vitamins can be vitamin B complex and vitamin C, whereas fat-soluble is vitamin A, D, E, and K. So particularly coming to vitamin C, which is also known as ascorbic acid, vitamin C is a water-soluble anti-scurvy vitamin. Very important point to be noted, it is water-soluble as well as anti-scurvy. Scurvy is basically a dental disorder and vitamin C prevents this disorder. It is modified simple sugar that is not synthesized by the human body, and so we take it from an outer source or outer diet. Stress and increased ACTH level can lead to increased secretion of ascorbic acid from the adrenal. It is highly concentratedly found in the pituitary, adrenal, eyes and platelets and sometimes the white blood cells. Moving ahead to the functions of vitamin C, it helps in collagen formation by the connective tissue by hydroxylation of proline to hydroxyproline. So basically vitamin C will change proline into hydroxyproline, which will lead to collagen formation of the connective tissue, which further helps in early wound healing. Vitamin C is a rich source of antioxidant also. Coming to the daily requirement of vitamin C, usually it is recommended that daily requirement should be amongst 30 to 70 mg in different countries, but as in the case of pregnancy and lactation, it can be increased by 20 to 40 mg. Now if you see to the sources of vitamin C, in vegetable sources we have guavas, potatoes, cauliflowers and some citrus fruits like lemon and oranges. Animal sources can be meat, liver, kidney fish, cabbage, Brussels sprouts, green peppers. These are some of the examples of vitamin C. Coming to the deficiency of vitamin C. Now, what if you are not taking efficient of vitamin C in your diet? What can be the challenges that can be faced if you are not taking enough of vitamin C? They can be anorexia, pain in the limbs, subperiosteal hemorrhage, gingivitis, scurvy and anemia in children. But if I talk about the adults, including all these features, there can be ecchymosis, delayed wound healing, perifollicular hemorrhage. Amongst these some deficiency features, we have some other features like bleeding of the skin and the mucus. Gingivitis can lead to loosening of the tooth, dry and rough skin, joint and body ache, fatigue and depression, lethargy, increased susceptibility to any kind of infection, and also muscle weakness. Coming to these pictures, these are some of the pictures of vitamin C scurvy. So if you have deficiency of vitamin C and you have this kind of painful bleeding gums, this can be scurvy. Moving ahead, vitamin C has been widely used as a mega vitamin therapy because it claims that it can prevent certain kind of infections like common cold. But do you know that even the overdosage of vitamin C can be harmful? It can lead to hypervitaminosis C. Oxalate crystals, when passed in the urine, can precipitate the oxalate and stone formation. So whenever you take excess or overdoses of vitamin C, what will happen is certain oxalate crystals are going to come in your urine and they will form oxalate stone formation in the body. Long-term use of vitamin C can interfere in the absorption of vitamin B12 in the body and can lead to vitamin B12 deficiency anemia. So this was all about vitamin C uses, side effects and dosage and what can be the sources for vitamin C. I hope the video was helpful to you. Like, share and subscribe. Thank you so much.